Accounting for Beginners number 27. Thank you for coming back again. This is my classic series. If this is your first time, hit subscribe so you can see more. If you're back, if this is like your 27th video watching me, go see a therapist to make sure you're okay. So let's just get right into it. Accounting for Beginners number 27, let's go. I think this is the last video of does the transaction increase asset? What's a transaction? Paid a utility bill, $500. Let's make our journal entry first and then we're gonna answer the question. You have no idea about anything. You hurry up and write DC Adler on your paper. Then, as you've been doing, as you've been practicing every morning for a month straight, 2 months straight, you know what this is in your brain, but you're just gonna write it out on your test paper anyways. DC Adler. Debit, credit, asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue. These are in the positive forms. That's an X, that's not a plus. I swear to God, what's wrong with me sometimes? What I would do, I would just start writing a journal entry, but even though sometimes I still write this. Debits and credits. I still do this sometimes for me, even though I'm like 10 years deep. Sometimes, I don't know. Just so I can see it, kind of, so I can see the different sides coming out. But I'll put a debit, credit. Now, once again, I found the best way to find neither good nor bad, bad or good, left and right. Debit is the left side of the double entry accounting equation or the journal entry. Debit is the left side. Credit is the right side, and they're always going to equal, just always going to equal. So I pretty much love this, the double entry accounting system. Once you learn it, you don't forget it, it doesn't change, and there's some steadfast rules. Steadfast rules being debit on the left, credit on the right side of the journal entry of the equation. They are always going to equal. So I'll put an equal signs here. Always getting equal. Like when you're on accounting software where you're doing bookkeeping like QuickBooks or Easy Accounting or whatever system you might be using to write down journal entries, you can't leave the page or you can't leave the transaction if the debits and credits don't equal. So it's just a very steadfast rule. Does the transaction increase assets? I don't know what's the transaction. Paid a utility bill for $500. All right. So let's think. Paid a bill, $500. Do we have cash in here going in or out? First thing I like to do. Do we have cash here? Paid a utility bill, $500. Bing, 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 bing. We've got $500. They don't say cash, but paid. So that's money. That's my chippers, dog. So I got chippers going out. I got $500 going out. God damn, it goes fast, don't it, though? A lot faster out and in, huh? So look, bing, 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 bing. We've got $500 here. Now paid, in the perfect world they say, you have cash outgoing in the amount of $500. But cash outgoing also means paid somebody. Just, if you don't know, just think like, I paid somebody $2 that I owed them. I paid somebody $5. So what, here's your $5. So I have less cash, right? So we all know by this time, cash is an asset. What do we have? We have cash in a negative form. So here's how I see kind of assets. It's like going in here, going out over here. It's like, so we have $500 paid cash leaving our business. That's gonna be our credit. Cash is going to be our credit because it's leaving. And how much cash is leaving our bank account? How much cash is leaving our business? $500. what bucket is cash in? We already know that. It's in the asset bucket. There's our credit side, it's cash. Cash is an asset, $500. Go asset going down, so it's on the credit side. All right, so once again, yeah, we got cash, we got half our journal entry correct. Now, we are gonna move into our, now we're gonna move into our debit side. What did we do? What did we do with our $500? Like, yeah, over here, we know, you know, you spent $500 on something. What'd you spend it on? What'd you spend it on? A utility bill. All right. Utility bill. For your business, if you spend money and you have no idea what it is, I would say you could just, if you have no idea, just put an expense, because most likely that's why you spend, most likely money coming out of your bank account is to is on things to try to help you with your business, and that's a business expense. Money coming out, business expense if it's for the business. So utility bill, assuming it's coming out of your business account, so it is at your office, whatever. Utility bill, it doesn't say monthly, but I think, you know, usually utility bills are monthly. If you paid a year in advance, then it might be an asset, but that's a different story. So, a utility bill is an expense. You would know that, and so expense in the positive form is a debit. Or, let's say you had no idea what category utility bill is. You have no idea. Is utility bill an asset? Is it a draw? Is it an expense? Is liability, equity, revenue? I guess just a little hack here. You could just, you know, these always have to equal. You could just put utility bill. You have no idea, utility bill. You could just put that in the debit. And how much? How much is it gonna equal? How much was the utility bill for? $500. Also, you know, I always like to work from the cash first, but if you know utility bill, utility expense, you know, that's an expense, and you know, expense is a positive debit, you can write the utility bill first and go over to the cash and do the cash second. What's our journal entry? Debit, utility bill, $500. What's our credit? Cash, $500. Oh, I'm sorry. What's utility bill? Utility bill is an expense. Utility bill debit for $500 is our journal entry. And utility bill is an expense and is going up, because yes, our utility bill expense is going up because we just paid $500. So it's increasing by $500, our utility bill expenses. Our credit side, we have cash for $500. Cash is an asset. Since it's on the credit side, it's going down. Let it go here. And let's answer this mug. Do you guys know it? Pause. All right, you don't have to, you can. Back, nice. Does the transaction increase assets? Expense, well, that's not an asset, so we don't know. Oh, we have an asset over here, cash. Wait, it's going down. So we have assets going down. Not gonna happen, boy. Thank you so much for watching. I feel like I'm getting my rhythm back again a little bit. And working with a new camera here. I think 26, AFB 26 and 27 has got a new camera. So I'm working on like the focus and everything. Hope it's getting better. Anyways, I really appreciate you watching these. I really love making them.